Now, there may only be two of you walking down the aisle in the end, but the number of people that will help you plan the perfect wedding is far greater. We welcome back Brad Buckles from bridesclub.com to get some advice on how to choose the best wedding team possible, from florists to caterers and everyone in between. Good morning.
Hi, how are you?
I'm doing great. Thanks for coming back here today.
It's fun. So
when someone meets with a potential vendor, mm-hmm. what questions should they ask?
You know, a lot of times the brides are asking questions like, what do you do? What's the price? What kind of packages do you have? And they don't understand the importance of actually sitting down with the vendor face to face and really understanding who the vendor is. In Hawaii, it's so easy to understand that we're personable. We like relationships. And yet sometimes when it comes to hiring a wedding professional, they forget that and they want to go straight online and just figure it out.
So you're saying people are not meeting with the vendors face-to-face? How they're just choosing someone?
They go to Yelp, they go to WeddingWire, they go to The Knot, and then sometimes a wedding professional will say, well, let's sit down and meet for a second. Let's get to know each other a bit. And the brides are pulling back and going, well, let me just see how much you are, or let me see what mm-hmm. you do, let me go to your website. And they forget that that face-to-face contact is so important. You're going to spend your most important day with somebody that you may not end up liking.
Wow. Okay, so what are some of the questions that you should ask them?
I think it's really important to find out how long that vendor has been in business, because I think there's a huge difference with somebody that's just getting started and somebody who's been around for 10 or 15 years.
They've worked out all the kinks.
Yeah. You don't want a batter going into opening day that you found out was just brand new last year. You want a batter who's been involved for several years.
Mm-hmm. What are some of the characteristics that you should look for when choosing a vendor?
Somebody who is low stress. Somebody who's friendly, somebody who has several ideas on what they can provide for you. In other words, you go to them with a decor idea and they say, well, let's do this or let's do this or let's do this. You choose on what you want, but if something goes wrong between today and your wedding day, they have the ability to improvise a bit.
Okay. It's true, because sometimes you go in with a budget even,
oh,
right?
Oh, yeah, there's the budget.
the big budget. And they end up doing something that you didn't ask for that costs a lot more.
That's why it's so important to have it in writing, which is the other big tip, is you got to make sure from all your emails to your texts to your contract to all the little other communications that happen, keep it all in writing. Because if you've given them a direction on this got to cost this much or it has to be done this way, that's got to be binding. Mm-hmm. You got to be able to have a professional who's going to respect that.
And when I like what you said about making sure that they work well under stress.
Oh, yeah.
Because you don't want a vendor coming up to you on your wedding day, you know, freaking out.
It's the bride's day. It's not the wedding planner's day. It's not the florist's day. And the bride is foremost. She gets the spotlight. Everybody else has to fall behind. And the real good professionals know this. They know when to drop back. They know when to tell the photographer to do this or how to do it. You don't want all that scuttlebutt happening in the back.
Right. Now, you mentioned the importance of meeting a vendor face-to-face.
Oh, yeah.
So how else should people do their research?
I think you ask around. You ask a lot of your friends, which makes common sense. But I've heard so many stories of people that just didn't check. They met somebody, all the photos on the website look great, and they just went with it. Mm-hmm. And they don't get it in writing. They give somebody a deposit. That person changes or moves. There's a makeup artist in Hawaii right now who's known for showing up to the wedding late. And her weddings typically show up like 30 minutes late walking down the aisle. And she's still in business. And you mm-hmm. kind of go like, how many times does that happen before somebody goes, knock it off?
Right.
But they don't talk. They don't spread the word. So you can go do your online research with like Yelp. But you have to understand that you're going to get what you read, and not everything you read is right.
Mm-hmm.
That goes both ways with what they say on their websites and what they say on the reviews. So read and look around and then ask a lot of questions.
All right, Brad, that's wonderful advice. When you think of weddings in Hawaii, you immediately think of Brad Buckles.
Well, thank you.
So thank you for being here and sharing your knowledge with us.
Thank you.
July is a big month for you guys.
We have our 25th annual Hawaii Bridal Expo in July. This is our big celebrational year, and you were there one of the very beginning.
Yes, yeah. I think we showed some pictures yesterday.
Yeah, we had to look for those.
I know, way deep in the boxes.
But I've gotten so many comments on how beautiful you look then and how you just haven't even changed.
I don't know about that, but thank you so much. thank you.